databases must store sensitive data, and there must be something different about securing data that is stored in a database compared to what we've been talking about before. So what we discussed before is data stored in files, for example. When we did access control, we said you have read-write permissions on files. Databases we're going to discuss are somewhat different, although they also store data, but it's different, and the fact that they store lots of data that is sensitive, that's what makes this topic important. So databases actually do store massive amounts of sensitive data. This could be, if you are a company, could be your customer data. In fact, when we talk about some company getting hacked and large amounts of their customer data, such as their social security number or date of birth or address, credit card numbers, when those being stolen by hackers, databases store data that we're going to see needs to be accessed in a certain way. And the reason we're able to do that is because databases can store what is called data in a structured form. And the kind of the examples that I just talked about, the data that we have about customer records or health records, that data does have structure. And the structure actually influences how it's going to get accessed. So I may ask, for example, information about all customers who purchased some number of things in the last 2 months. So asking this kind of a query or formulating this kind of a query or a question that we want to run against the database, we make use of the structure that is there in this data to do that. So what we really do is that think about a database storing structured data, and then we can basically access it through programs called queries that we submit to it. These programs or queries are written in a language that is designed for accessing data stored in databases. One common one is SQL, which stands for Structured Query Language. So we're going to talk about accessing data from databases using SQL quite a bit. This is another thing that is different about databases. Databases also store data that is persistent, like files. And of course, we need integrity of the data. One way to do that is we have this transactional nature of queries or programs that we run on the database. A transaction means either the program runs completely, does everything it's supposed to do, or whatever it did gets undone. Transaction, either we have the 0 or 1 property, either it's done completely or not done at all kind of a thing. By running a partial transaction, for example, a query could leave the database in a state where it's not consistent, and that impacts the integrity. Finally, databases, another thing that's kind of different about them is that we can sort of create a virtual database, what is called a database view. This is really derived data that's there in the database. So for example, you may want to choose a subset of the information that's stored in the database. So you can run a query against the database, and the result could be another sort of virtual database, also called a database view, and then users can have access to that view.